Hey, boys and girls.
I'm going to talk to you today about a word called value. All right, value is the light to dark of a color. So here I have my pencil and I have my piece of paper. And Miss Winger said I needed to do value all over all of my paper. So value just means that I'm going to turn my pencil on its side. Let me get a clipboard. You want to start draw really, really, really light, okay? So, I'm going to hold down here at the end because there's a difference. Everybody see those hard texture lines? We don't want hard texture lines. We want to hold down here at the end. We want to be really, really smooth. We want to be light, 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 light. So light that maybe not even the person sitting beside of you, beside of you can see. Okay? So if I wanted that to be a little bit darker instead of just adding more pressure with my pencil, I'm just going to do more layers. So see, I'm doing the same pressure, but I'm going to add more layers. So for your projects that you're doing all different types of yummy treats, right? We're doing sweet, sweet life. So as you're drawing, let's say I wanted to draw my cupcake. I'm going to do a little mini one. So I want to draw really light. I want to do that outline first so I can kind of figure out what's going on so I can see my cupcake's going to be sitting kind of here on a table. See how I'm not just drawing one line once, right? I'm adding more lines. The more lines I add, what happens to my picture? Does it get darker or lighter? That's right, it gets darker. Okay, more and more and more and more lines. I also encourage you to look at your picture that you're drawing from. That way you can see, oh, well, the top of my cherry, if you're doing your cupcake, the top of my cherry was almost to the top of that paper. So I know that that's where the top of mine goes. And that plate was almost touching the bottom of that image. So that will show you how far down you need to go. Okay, so I'm just going light, and then you can always go back over top of your lines to create a darker value. So I can't just leave this blank, because that's showing Miss Wingross that you just gave up. So I'm going to go really, really, really light. Kind of like our paintings. You don't want to just leave an area blank on your canvas. Now, this is something that you can practice on your practice paper before you move on to final surface so that you are a master. Now, there's some other techniques that you can use to blend. You can use your finger, but your finger might get really kind of dirty. On your tables, I have these Q-tips. So, experiment on your practice paper. See, it comes off on here too. Experiment and see how that blending with that Q-tip works. Some of you might like it, some of you might not like it, some of you might love it and want to use it all the time. That's cool. For this project, our drawing project, you are only using pencil. Only using what? Pencil. That's right. I can't wait to see what we all come up with.